गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9th की. बेटा वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस पोएम टुडे एंड दिस इज द ओनली पोएम व्हिच इज लेफ्ट फॉर टर्म 1. यू माइट हैव गॉन थ्रू द सिलेबस आई हैव सेंट ऑलरेडी सर्कुलेटेड इन व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप एंड ऑल द पोएम्स फॉर द टर्म 1 वी हैव कंप्लीटेड. दिस इज अ पोएम ओनली, अ लेजेंड. A legend of the Northland. Now I would be telling you firstly what is a legend. If anybody has the idea what is a legend, they can raise hand and speak up. And if you don't know, I would be telling you, no problem. What is a legend? Nobody knows. So in very simple language, legend is, legend means a traditional tale. A legend means a traditional tale. Tale means a story. T-A-L-E. Tale means story. So a traditional tale. Clear? Now Northland, you know that you have various sides, various countries fall into the category of Northland. We are on page 65, beta. Kindly note down. My voice is audible to everyone. Send me thumbs up. Yes, thank you. So we would be reading about a traditional story. It can be historical story. It can be any fairy tale, anything related to any topic. Fine, so we call it a legend. But this is not required that this story will be based on true facts. No. It can be an imaginary story also. Sometimes your grandparents tell you a tale so that you imbibe some values in you. Though the tale is having fictional characters only. Fictional means imaginary characters. But it does teach you a moral lesson. In that way, A Legend of the Northland is beautiful poem. It will be narrating a legend or a story to us. There is a story within this poem. Fine. Now, be very careful. There are categories of poems. If a poem narrates a story, then we call it a ballad. You have book and on page number beta 67. Just have a look. Page number 67 of your book. A ballad is a song narrating a story in short stanzas. Ballads are a part of folk culture or popular culture and are passed on orally from one generation to the next. Clear? A Legend of the Northland is a ballad. So what we are going to read today, obviously this is a poem, but which category of poem, if I ask you, you should know. This is a ballad form of poetry. Fine? Because there is a story in this poem. Otherwise, poem can be about nature, about happiness, about anything. So we will be reading a story in this poem, A Legend of the Northland. That is a traditional tale. Fine? Clear? So I would be sharing the screen with you all now. Fine? So you have noted down. Greed is a grave sin. Means in this tale, in this poem or ballad, we would be reading about greediness. That how becoming greedy, how will lead to your end. Greed is a grave sin. Grave means better serious. Paap, sin. So one should not be greedy enough. One should be ready to share with others always. Sharing is caring. This is the, you can say, one lesson we learned from this ballad. Have empathy for others. Sympathy is when you feel bad for others, fine, and you want to sympathize with them that they should lead good life and all. Empathy is when you yourself feel the pain. That if I will be in the place of this person, what will happen then? One need to empathize with others, okay? Have empathy for others is the second theme. As you sow, so shall you reap. Jaisa boge, vaisa katoge. In that way, whatever you will be doing, karma will follow you back. Whatever karmas you are doing, whatever deeds you are doing, you have to reap accordingly. Okay? So this is the third theme. Send me thumbs up if the themes are clear to all of you. Class 9D, come on fast. All the three themes are clear? Yes. Most of you are saying yes. Okay, fine. So now I would be telling you the background. So kindly open your books. Let me share the screen. Yes, Vijay. The poem narrates the legend of an old lady who angered Saint Peter because of her greed. Clear? So there are two characters mainly. First is Saint Peter. Underline, it's written over there only. Fine. Saint Peter is the first character, the prominent character. And second one is an old lady. Two characters are there only. Fine. So, this poem narrates the legend of an old lady who angered Saint Peter because of her greed. This old lady is very greedy. She is not at all ready to share what she bakes with others for free of cost, because she is into the baking business for earning purpose. So this is the background, a brief background I'm telling you. Saint Peter was a saint, as it's related with his name only. And he would go from one place to another place. And as you know that saints, they do not have any businesses and all. They seek food and shelter from others only. So Saint Peter was fasting those days. He was on fast and he was about to have food at night time. He would be opening that fast and he wanted to have something to eat. He was direly hungry and he would be ending up meeting this old lady, and he would expect that this old lady would give him a piece of cake, because she is into baking cakes and all. And he was expecting that she would feed him properly and nicely. But the lady promised him that, yes, I will give you this, I will bake a cake for you. But every time when she bakes, the cake came out to be a big one. Or because, why big one? Because she herself is having very small, you can say, thoughts. Thinking level is very narrow. She, every time she bakes a cake, she thinks that, this seems to be large enough, big piece enough, big portion. I should cook or I should bake small portion for this saint. Again, she keeps the cake aside. Again, she says, okay, Saint Peter, I'm going to give you another one. She bakes another piece of cake. It was again, she says, okay, this also, usse chota, ye bhi bada lag raha hai. Okay, let me bake another one. Then keeps on saying, and when she's left with last piece of cake, she would be offering a wafer only, itna patla cake, this just like a wafer. You know that crunchy or wafer that people eat. Saint Peter was dying with hunger. He got annoyed. See, this lady is very bad, who does not have empathy for others. Aagayi na theme aapki. She does not have empathy for others. She is not ready to share proper food with me. So what should I do? What will he do? That we'll be reading in this legend. I'm not going to disclose it. Okay? Away, away in the north land. where the hours of the day are few and the nights are so long in winter, and they cannot sleep them through. Means in the first stanza of this ballad, this poem, poet, who is the poet? Cord Skinny is the poet. Sorry, Phoebe Carey is the poet. Phoebe Carey is the poet, fine. He says that away in the Northland, where days are shorter than the nights, nights are longer. You know, it varies from place to place. Nighttime, darkness prevail earlier than in India or in other countries in Northland. The countries which fall into the category of Northland. You can search on net also which countries fall into Northland. So, and the nights are so long in winter that they cannot sleep them through. Nights are so long that people are not able to sleep for so many hours, obviously. Where they harness the swift reindeer to the sledges when it snows. It means Northland, beta, it is considered very cold place. These countries are quite cold, that snowfall is there, that people are using sledges to do that sledging on the ice, you might have seen. Have you seen during the Christmas days when Santa Claus comes, there is a reindeer which is bound there with the sledge of that Santa Claus. Reindeer is there, fine. So he's saying that this is the place is so cold that where you can find sledges, where it is snowing all the day, where reindeer, swift means fast movement. You can find reindeers. It means poet is telling us the weather of the Northland, which is very cold, quite cold. And the children look like bear's cubs. Look like bear cubs. Which poetic device is used? Come on, raise your hand. Children look like bear's cubs. Which poetic device is used? Yes, Titiksha, you can speak louder.
Simile.
Yes, simile is... you can mute yourself, beta. Clear? Look like bear's cub means they have dressed up their children by making them wear sweaters and jackets and other woolen stuff that they are looking like bears because they are dressed up in various layers because it is very cold there. So this is the way of describing that it is quite cold over there, okay? Children look like bear's cubs in their funny furry clothes. Now, this line in the funny means they look very funny because they're looking chubby and cute and, you know, bear-like appearance. Fur. You might have seen during winters we wear fur because fur is that cloth which makes us warm. Fine? Now, which poetic device is used in this furry, funny, furry clothes? Come on, raise your hand. Tiksha cannot answer it now. Funny, furry clothes. Raise your hand. Come on, fast. First sound is repeated. Funny, furry clothes. I'm giving you the hint also. Which poetic device is used here? Divya, can you answer this? Funny, furry clothes, which poetic device?
Ma'am, I forgot.
Sorry?
Ma'am, I forgot.
Okay, you forgot. Nobody knows. Okay, let me tell you then. Alliteration. When a consonant sound is repeated, beta, then it is called alliteration. Fine? In funny, furry clothes. Which poetic device? Alliteration. So these stanzas we would be reading now. They tell them a curious story. I don't believe it's true. And yet you may learn a lesson if I tell the tale to you. So poet here says, the place of Northland, which is very cold, where nights are longer than days, where children look like bears when they are dressed up with wearing jackets. There, a story, a curious means interesting. Story is famous and I don't believe it's true. So poet is telling us that this legend, obviously it's a legend, a traditional tale, which is told by ancestors to their grandchildren. It is not true. Poet is telling us, but though it is not true, but we can learn a lesson out of it. We can imbibe some values out of it if I tell the tale to you. Again, alliteration is used here, beta. T sound is repeated. Tell the tale. Underline it. I won't be making you do the devices separately. Keep on noting down. Tell the tale means T sound is repeated. Alliteration. He's saying, if I tell or I narrate the story to you, then you will realize that you will learn a lesson out of it. Once when the good Saint Peter lived, here, beta, the story starts. Fine. So be very, very attentive. I can ask any one of you. Once when the good Saint Peter lived in the world below and walked about it preaching just as he did, you know. So poet is saying, once there was a Saint Peter who was very religious personality, having powers. He lived in the world below. It means when he was living on this earth. Fine. He was so saintly persona. He was when he took birth on this earth and he was walking here and there preaching. Preaching means sermonizing. Preaching means imbibing values in others by teaching them, sermonizing them. Just the saints do. You might have seen many saints keep on telling us good things always. So once there was a Saint Peter. Now, he came to the door of a cottage and traveling round the earth where a little woman was making cakes and baking them on the hearth. Anybody can tell me what is the rhyme scheme of this stanza? Rhyme scheme A, B, C, D, 1. Don't get confused, fine? Cottage is A, earth is B. Cake is C and hearth is again B. So it is A, B, C, B. A, B, C, B, small one, okay? He's saying that Saint Peter came to a cottage and he knocked at the door while traveling around the earth. A little old woman was making cakes and actually she was baking the cakes on a hearth. Hearth is better that firing place where you keep. They're not talking about ovens and OTGs and fine microwave. They're talking about hearth where, you know, in previous times, people used to have big fireplaces and they would keep the trays with proper oiling and material. And with the heat of that wood or coal, they would bake the things. So she's having a big hearth in which she's baking the cakes. So Saint Peter happens to reach that cottage of this old woman. And being faint with fasting, again, alliteration is used here, faint with fasting. F sound is repeated here. For the day was almost done. The day was about to finish and Saint Peter had been fasting whole day. He was so hungry. He asked her from her store of cakes to give him a single one. He asked her, can you give me a single cake out of your store of cakes? That you are having so many cakes, can you give me one? Because I'm hungry. So she made a very little cake, but as it baking lay, she looked at it and thought it seemed too large to give away. She made a little cake. And when she put that cake for baking, you know that when we have to put batter all around and then after preparing the batter, we have to keep the cake for baking, obviously. When she put that cake for baking, she had a look and she thought it's too large. I should not give a big cake to this man. I should give a small one, a smaller one. It's too large to give away. Therefore, she needed another and still a smaller one. But it looked, when she turned it over, as large as the first one. She did not give the first cake to Saint Peter. She kept it aside. She thought, I should bake smaller one. Let's knead. Kneading, you know that? Atta gunte ho jaise. Or putting the mixture all together and preparing the batter of the cake. She started kneading another. She started preparing the another batter. Still a smaller one. It was a small cake only. But it looked, when she turned it over, when it started baking, you know that it changes its size after baking, as large as the first head. And she thought, it is just like the first cake only. It is also big. She dropped the idea of giving the second cake also to Saint Peter. Yes, send me thumbs up if any, if all clear, if you are able to understand each and every word, expression. Let me have a look at my students. Divya, Aryan, Riyanshika, Jia, Lisa, Surveen. I'm checking those who are sitting. Dharya. What about others? Come on fast. Yes, Deeksha has switched on the video to show that she is listening to me. I know that those who are students on daily basis. Harmeet, Gagan, Charvi, send me thumbs up. Otherwise, I'll consider it to be absent one. Yes, Bhavansh is there, Gagan is there. Fine. Clear. So, you are able to understand this interesting legend? This ballad, fine? Let's continue. Again, she baked the second cake. She thought, this again seems to be larger one. What should I do? Then she took a tiny scrap of dough that she was going to turn into that cake. So dough she was having, the prepared stuff to bake cake, and rolled it flat. She started rolling the dough and baked it thin as a wafer. As a wafer, simile. Underline, as a wafer, means just like a wafer. She was baking a cake. Cake is a thick one, but she just baked a thin wafer. Itna patla kar diya usne. But she could not part with that also. After baking a thin wafer, she was so greedy, so miser, that she could not give that wafer also to Saint Peter. For she said, my cakes that seem too small when I eat of them myself are yet too large to give away. So she put them on the shelf. Try to understand this. She says, when I eat my cake myself, then it seems so small. When she will be eating that wafer cake, she will think, oh, very small. Let me eat more. But when she is supposed to give it to others, then it's very difficult to give it for free. You know, I give you one example, beautiful example. When you are going somewhere, you see a beggar on the street. Fine, you see a beggar and you start searching if you want to give amount, you start searching in your bag or purse. The smallest entity, the smallest coin, 1 rupee, 2 rupee, 5 rupee, okay. Will you give 100 rupees or 200 rupees or 500 rupee note to the beggar? No. We people have such mentality. But at the same time, when you go to have your burgers and pizzas at branded locations where you are spending 400 for one burger or 500 for one meal, then you are ready to pay. You just see which is the best meal I should pay for. Okay, this is for 140 only. No, this is not good. I should pay 500 for my quality food. This is our human psychology. We people are ready to pay a more amount for us, for ourselves, but when it comes to helping others, when it comes to empathizing with others, then we find the smallest coin in the corner of the purse. We keep searching. We never part away with 100 or 200 rupees, but because it's difficult for us. This is the reality. Clear? My cakes that seem too small when I eat of myself are yet too large to give away. So she put them on the shelf. So she could not part with that wafer. She took that wafer and put it on the shelf again. Did not give it to Saint Peter. Then we are left with 5 minutes, beta. Two stanzas we can do. That's it. After that, ignorance. Then good Saint Peter grew angry, for he was hungry and faint, and surely such a woman was enough to provoke a saint. I did not tell you what happened next in the beginning. Now you will get to know. Good Saint Peter. Saint Peter was a very noble personality. He got angry because he was very hungry, and with the hunger, he was about to faint even because he had been fasting for so long. And surely such a woman, such a shameless woman, was enough to provoke us. And she was enough at that time when you are hungry, you know, and somebody is talking to you, you're not able to concentrate even. He was so hungry that he was provoked. Clear? So bell has gone. I can't continue. We will know tomorrow that what happened, what Saint Peter did, and what happened to that old little woman. Okay? Have a nice day, beta. Keep reading and keep learning.